The government of Uganda has repossessed the power generation plants of Narubali and Chila dams in Jinja after their contract with Eskom Uganda Limited, a South African company, came to an end. The Minister of Energy has assured the nation of a reduction in power tariffs as the government takes full control of the power generation. The handover ceremony took place at Narubali Power Station and was presided over by the Minister in charge of Minerals, Peter Lokeris, who represented the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, Honorable Ruth Nankabira Sentamu, and attended by government officials from the Ministries of Energy and Mineral Development, Finance, Planning and Economic Development, Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited, Electricity Regulatory Authority, Department of Water Resources Management, and representatives from Eskom Uganda Limited, Eskom Enterprises, and the South African High Commissioner to Uganda.
The procedure is good. We will do it.
The chief guest, Peter Aimat Lokeris, the Minister of State for Minerals, thanked Eskom Uganda Limited for the great contribution to Uganda's energy sector over the years.
This plant, the way it has been maintained by Eskom, and do more improvement for the good of the country and for the years to come. I thank you.
The most expensive power generated now is Bujagali. And Bujagali is run by the private sector. Even Isimba, is a government owned, is generating cheaper electricity. Karuma is also going to generate cheaper electricity. If I can bring everything to be operated by government, the power tariffs will come down. So all these things are being done because, as I said in my speech, I'm pro-people. We must get everybody connected to electricity, but it should be affordable. So this one is done as a measure to reduce the tariffs.
The managing director of Eskom gave an account of the power's company operations for the past 20 years.
Worth highlighting include the age of the Narubali plant, which requires constant upgrade, with equipment being not supported anymore. We have encountered rapid technology advancements, which we had to keep up with to ensure that the plant has the relevant technology to operate.
Uganda Electricity Transmission Company Limited CEO, who received the power stations from the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development, committed to continued investment and maintenance of the government assets.
The plant is old. I think it has served its purpose. And like the MD indicated, we are going to need major investments into this plant to keep it running. Now, they told you that UEGCL, we are the asset owner, and we were not sleeping. We have completed a feasibility study for rehabilitating the plant so that we can increase its service life for another 30 or 40 years.
The handover ceremony marks the end of a successful 20-year concession between Eskom Uganda and the Ugandan government. Report compiled by Ivan Lubega for the news.